Six Sigma apply to our product that is Strawberry Jam. Our group includes Natalie Pagan, Christian Chavez, Rocio Gutierrez, Fran Ludeña, and Stephanie Rojas. We have to touch 5 points. Define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. The points to trigger several problems, Sigma level, cause and effect diagram, EFMEA, and new Sigma level. First point, several problems. The problem with the Strawberry Jam is the product don't have vacuum seal. And we know we shouldn't consume a product when the bottle is open because it means a microbiological problem. It affects our health. In the second point, we have Sigma level. If we produce 10,000 units per week, we have approximately 334 defects. And from our flux chart, we have 11 steps that result in 21 opportunities. If we can calculate the defects per opportunities, we have to divide the defects by the unit produced by the opportunities. And finally, we have this amount. Then we have to multiply the result for 1 million. And we obtain 1,590. Finally, we have to see the DPMO table and interpolate to obtain the level. In this case, it's 4.4753. First point, we have cause and effect diagram. And we have 4 points in this part. The first point is packaging machine that is originated by a low temperature. The second point, employees, is about bad training and inexperience. The third point, storage, includes transport and GSP. And finally, we have the cooling that is originated by a low cooling time. Now I'm going to explain the Pareto chart. We have 5 defects: the inexperience, the lack of training, the low packaging, the low packing temperature, not enough cooling time, and incorrect GMP. We have the number of incidents, the total percentage, and the cumulative percentage. If we see the graphic, we can see the inexperience and the lack training origins incorrect sealing of the yard.
So we're going to talk about the fourth point, which is FMEA, which is failure mode and effect analysis. And the first thing we're going to talk about is packaging and the potential failure mode, which is that the product doesn't arrive at the right temperature for packaging. And potential effects of this failure is that there isn't enough space or left in the jar for the correct treatment of the jam. And the severity of this is 9, which is on a scale of 1 to 10, so it's a pretty severe problem. And potential causes of mechanism of failure is the training and knowledge of the workers on the machines and the processes. And the occurrence is 5, so it occurs pretty often. Current design controls is just training personnel on how to use the equipment and how to know the processes. But the recommended actions for this is to measure the temperature before and during the process of packaging, and also have a supervisor who is aware of what is needed to be done and what is correct. The second thing we're going to talk about is the sealing of the jars, and the failure mode for this is that the jar is not sealed correctly. And the potential effects of failure is that if the jar is not sealed correctly, then that allows oxygen and microorganisms to enter into the jar, which later will cause growth of bacteria, which is harmful for, you know, the public and the company itself and their image. And potential failures of this is, again, because of improper training or improper knowledge of the processes or the machines used. And the occurrence of this is 7, so it's a pretty, it occurs a lot more than the actual temperature of the packet or the jam mopping package. And the recommended actions to prevent this is to just watch when the seal is being placed in onto the jar and making sure that it's actually sealed correctly and that there's a vacuum that occurs so that the jar or the jam is in a jar that is sealed tight. And again, have a supervisor that oversees the operations to make sure everything is running smoothly. And then finally, we have the cooling of the jar after the jam has been in there and sealed. And this allows that the jam actually solidifies, so it becomes more of a jam-like texture versus a liquid.
So we have the new Sigma level, and that is still with 10,000 units per week. And the defects have decreased, so now we only have 175 defects, and the opportunities are still 21. And we have the defects per opportunity, so 175 divided by 10,000 for 21 gives us this number. And we also have, then we have to multiply this number by 1,000, we get 800. And our new number is 4.904.
To reduce the numbers of defects, we will have a higher sigma level. For this to be possible, we take the corrective actions previously mentioned.